Hey, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to another Genshin Impact video, guys. Today we're gonna be talking about something you all are looking forward to, maybe. Well, I'm hoping you are, cause we're gonna be talking about it today. We're basically going to go over KAZUHA and what you're gonna probably need for his ascension materials, just so you can get ready before he comes out. So as we all know, Klee is gonna come out in the 1.6 first banner that's gonna be releasing. And I'm not sure what weapon banner is going to be coming out with Klee, or else it's going to stay the same. I'm not quite sure. I forgot what happened with youll and Zhongli. I'm sure they changed the weapon banner according to the main unit that's there. So keep that in mind. So KAZUHA is going to be coming out second. And why that's important is because during 1.6, you're going to get a new boss. I'm assuming with this new boss, you're going to get a new boss drop. Because of this, I want to mention to you guys, the whole new boss, whatever it is, and what he drops is probably going to be what KAZUHA uses as his ascension material, just like how we saw with the cry hypostasis and youll. But I'm pretty sure you won't be needing to fight this boss at all. You don't have KAZUHA. If you don't have KAZUHA, or if you're not planning to get KAZUHA, this new boss would be pretty much fun for 5 minutes, and they're not gonna be using him or needing to fight him for anything else. I find that a little bit unfortunate, because this boss looks super cool, and honestly, because of how he looks like a Zhao boss. It's really surprising how this one wasn't released for Zhao himself, but it is what it is. Anyways, we're moving on. We're going to be talking about what his mob drop will be. His mob drop would be, it could be a multiple things. But let's just go over. So what it could be is, it could be these, the ominous masks. But because youll just came out using these, I doubt it's going to be one of those. I think it could be these as well. The whole insignia stuff. But I doubt it's these either. I think it's gonna be these treasure hoarder insignias, just because you can see that we have a lot of them, and it's because no new characters came out and they used. I'm assuming it's gonna be these for the boss drop. I have no idea, but as we're seeing a trend in which new characters come out with new boss drops, I'm assuming the boss drop for this one is going to be some KAZUHA boss drop. I'm not really quite sure which one it was, or should be, or maybe. So, I mean, that's a little unfortunate. You're going to need a lot of Mora. So if you guys want to gather Mora today, or tomorrow, or now is the right time to gather Mora. Just so you can have enough to fully ascend him once he fully comes out. Because you're going to need a bunch. So to fully ascend him, we're going to need around 420,000 Mora, which is a lot. But the, leveling up factor, you have to also factor in. You're going to have to also farm the ley lines for the character ascension material. Alright, so something else to also mention is what weapon he might be using. So KAZUHA is going to be a sword, weapon user. And you have a lot of swords in the game. A lot, and I mean a crazy amount. And I'm gonna tell you guys a few of the good ones that are gonna be in here. Black sword, the black cliff sword, which I do not own. I think that one's gonna be pretty okay to use as well. The prototype rancor, I'm not quite sure. I don't think this is gonna be an okay weapon for him. The iron sting, this might be a good weapon for him, just because it has elemental mastery, and obviously dealing elemental damage is increased. So this might be a good weapon for him, not quite sure. But these are the swords that I think are viable. Would I think the sacrificial sword is viable? Hell no. I don't think this would be any good. Pavoni sword, I don't think so either. But it is what it is. So yeah, those are the swords. Maybe the Harbinger of Dawn is good on him. I'm not quite sure. So yeah, it is what it is. And I hope we see how good those weapons are, or I can test them out for you guys at least. This is an interesting weapon that we have as a 3-star. I'm not quite sure. Oh, here it is. The Dark Iron Sword. It has elemental mastery. Obviously, it is free. And so, causing overloaded superconduct, electrocharge, or an electro-infused swirl reaction, the attack is increased by 20%. I think this might be a pretty good sword for him, just because of the whole electro-infused swirl reaction. They're buffing electro itself, and now this has an electro infused reaction, so this might be a good sword for him. I don't know how big this attack percentage increase is gonna affect him, but I think it's gonna look pretty good. I kind of want to try this out. I might even consider leveling it up. But if you guys see in the trailer, he's using this, which is the fillet blade. On hit has 50% chance to do 240% attack damage to a single opponent, but it can only occur every 15 seconds. So the only thing I can see that's similar to is the prototype archaic, 50% chance to deal an additional 30% damage, but this is AoE, so this one's technically better. That's what it looks like. So all in all, just be prepared, gather a lot of Mora, gather a lot of Leyline materials if you want Kazuha, obviously if you want Klee as well. You're gonna have to do a lot of grinding from now, especially if you want to ascend them instantly. Also, Kazuha's gonna use the animal hypostasis material drop. So you're gonna grind the animal hypostasis as well, so make sure you do that. You only have a certain amount of resin every week, right? If you don't have the Serenity Pot, which you can just get 60 resin from as well, you're gonna lose out on a lot of resin. So make sure you use your resin correctly and properly, and make sure you guys make the most out of it, because that's what you want once he fully drops, just to get him fully ascended and ready to go. So yeah. Anyways, guys, that's gonna be it for the video. Hope you guys got something out of it. If you did, please subscribe to my channel or consider liking as well. That'd be greatly appreciated. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. And I'll see you guys in the next video very soon. Bye.